Shoes. Everybody wears them. Intended to protect and comfort the human foot, shoes are an important part of our daily life.
Wow, this is gonna be embarrassing. I think I have about 40 to 50 pairs of shoes.
I have at least 12 pairs of boots and 20 pairs of tennis shoes and in the 70 range, somewhere between 50 and 70, depending on what you count as a shoe.
I like to wear shoes that are different and interesting, but that are kind of neutral in color. I like them to have some kind of edge to them a little bit. So maybe it's a zipper, maybe it's some kind of Velcro closure, but I wear mostly black and gray and neutral colors, and so I need it to match everything that I wear.
Here are my favorite kinds of shoes. I have 5 pairs of Adidas. I love them. They're super comfortable and they look fly. I have lots of girly heels, some like super high ones, but the other kind of shoe that I have the most of are Doc Martens. I think they're amazing and they last forever.
I enjoy shoe shopping. I try to do it often, daily even. I don't buy something daily, but I look at shoes a lot.
If I could, I would shoe shop every day, and this is not even a lie. I probably buy a pair of shoes at least once a month.
While we're a running specialty store, very much enjoy running and making, it's kind of important that you get in the right type of shoe so that you don't get hurt while you're doing it. So kind of combines like passion for running. So this is a neutral shoe. This is a Mizuno. When you look at a neutral shoe, it's not gonna have any type of what we call a stability posting through the arch area. And the way that like a stability posting works is that after you strike on the heel or the midfoot, it's gonna control any motion over. Okay, so stability, there's gonna be a discoloration through the arch. So kind of a squishy foam here, less dense here. The idea of that is that after you're striking on the heel, when you start to pronate inwards, it's gonna control that movement and move you back to the neutral part of the shoe, which is this lace part here.
So the kind of the newest, it's not really, well, I guess the trend in running is a minimalist shoe, which is mimic barefoot running. It is going to encourage you to have a more midfoot to forefoot strike, which makes you a more efficient runner. And it's using, instead of using the cushion in the shoe, it is going to use your body as the cushion. So it's going to make you a little bit springier, a little bit faster.
Well, I know for bike riding, our pedals have these pins on the pedals, and the bottom of the shoe has different holes and stuff that the pins fit in, so it gives us a lot of grip on the pedal so we can stay on. For skateboarding, it's the same sort of thing. Those little holes grip onto the grip tape that's on top of the skateboard and provide a lot of traction, as well as the sides of the shoe and stuff from flipping it and doing different flip tricks. It's all about grip and traction and gripping the board. We got a red alert. We cut the power.
As you see, the bowling shoe, it has a leather bottom on it, as well as a rubber stop. So this gives the bowler to be able to slide, and this also stops them, so when they get to the lane, they're able to stop. As you can see, the way the bowling shoe looks, they almost look like clown shoes sometimes. But yeah, they're really unique.
Local shoe charity. We accept donated shoes, new and gently worn shoes, and we distribute them worldwide, locally, and nationally. Why do people need them? Haiti is a prime example. They have a very bad disease called singe. which is something like what you may see called elephantitis, where the feet and legs swell. And they're trying to prevent that, especially since the earthquake. They have seen the disease rise rapidly because of people have foot injuries and germs, bacteria is getting into their feet. So shoes are important. It's something that we don't really think much about because we have excess amount of shoes. You know, we have athletic shoes, we have dress shoes, and we change shoes 3 or 4 times a day. And we really don't give thought to those that don't have shoes, because there are over 3 billion children in the world who have never had a pair of shoes.